as a kid, you have the dream of like, I want to be a firefighter, or I want to be an astronaut, or I want to be a superstar, whatever. Like, I always knew that I wanted to be a musician, and I just never really outgrew the childhood dream of it. I was born in Toronto, Canada. I lived there until I was 3 years old, and then I moved to Normal, Illinois, and lived in the same house for the rest of my life up until college. Growing up, I would absolutely love going on bike rides, like out in the cornfields, and just seeing the great big blue sky and being able to see for miles and just let the warm air hit you and just like smell all the farmland. It was just the most beautiful thing. Bloomington Normal is such an amazing community. It's a substantial amount of people, but it's not overwhelming. I grew up in a household of music. There was absolutely no way that I was not just gonna be like slapped in the face with the idea of doing music as a career. And I look back at early childhood pictures and like almost all of them, I'm touching an instrument, or I'm watching my dad play an instrument, or I'm just surrounded by instruments. Make them go as you shoot across the sky. I've been singing forever. The way my tone has gotten to where it's at is by me literally like mimicking other singers. So I would kind of like be obsessed with the singer and kind of learn how they did what they did. And then I'd get obsessed with another singer and learn how they did what they did. And then like after so many years, it just became a huge melting pot of all these people that I admired and tried to like pick up certain things and leave other things. Eventually it just became something that felt just like me and like not like any of them, but yet they all are a part of what my voice is now. In junior high, I was obsessed with hockey. It was my life, and then I hit my head too many times, so I had to stop playing contact sports. I really like started to lean on music just in that time to console me, because my whole identity had just been like ripped away from me, and I was going into high school and I was like, I'm not the hockey girl anymore, like who am I? That's kind of where I started taking it more seriously. I just signed up for every musical opportunity I could, and it quickly like swallowed me whole. My whole high school career, I was just obsessed with the idea of going to Belmont University in Nashville. So after I graduated, I went to Belmont, and it was like a dream come true to go there. It was amazing, but very quickly, like within the first week of going there, I like just lost myself. I just wanted to do everything under the sun, and I'm only one human, and I could not keep up. I really ended up crashing very early on, and it was a very, very miserable 2 years of my life. After four semesters there, I dropped out and I came back home to Illinois, and then very shortly after, I really came back to myself for the first time in 2 years. I just had this idea of, I want to go travel the world and go find myself and just go be free and reevaluate everything. Where there's a way out, there's another way in. You can't close that door with the band-aid fix. Shortly after that, American Idol actually reached out, which was the last thing I ever thought I would do at that time. But I just had this weird gut feeling that was like telling me that I should just give it a shot, just have fun, see what happens.
So I'm here to play the game and roll the dice. I'm tossing in my coins, just name your price. Here's my 2 cents.
The entire American Idol process was honestly just the most fun I had in my entire life. People's lives are changed by this show. I don't think that's gonna be me, but I've watched this show forever, and it's just really cool that I'm even getting to be a part of it at all. The last 2 weeks of the show were when you really felt like a taste of, this is what it is to be a superstar. Like, you're flying on private jets, you're meeting all of your idols, you're singing with your idols. You're just in your own world when you're filming for Idol. You don't realize that everything is changing outside of this bubble. And then the last 2 weeks, you exit the bubble and you actually see what's going on.
Leah, you're going through. Put your hands
up. I would never believe you if you told me I made it to the finale on Idol. That was the last thing I ever expected. The finale happens, and a day later, you fly home on commercial, and you're just like, all right, what do I do now? You know, you really have like the rocket ship to the stratosphere. You just came off like the highest, quickest, most accelerated climb you could ever imagine in the industry. And you have to figure out what to do with all that momentum. And there's really no bridge from the show to help you figure out what the next steps are. You can view American Idol as my launch pad, and in a lot of ways it was, but it was the Midwest coming together around me during Idol that really was the launch pad. It was Central Illinois coming around me during that time that really made a huge difference. And so I think this place will always, always be my home. I love it here. I love coming home. But also just the people here, the fans here are just like, they're just like the day one people that have been watching me since I was 8 years old performing around town. So Illinois and Central Illinois will always have a special place in my heart. I don't want to be remembered for any certain thing. I think I just want to be remembered for the way that I make people feel. That's kind of the central guiding principle of my life.